everywhere.
Glenn Mack now. Now, Ray, it is time, as always, this time of the week when we check in, with our doctor from Abington Health, and it is Dr. Keith Gingrich today who joins us. Doc, how are you today?
Good, thank you. How are you?
Good, very well. Thank you very much. So, Dr. Gingrich, by the way, is a board-certified surgeon in orthopedic surgery, member of the American Academy of Orthopedic Society, immediate past president of the Philadelphia Orthopedic Society. But we want to talk groins, Doc.
Right.
Specifically, we want to talk Cody Parkey's groin, which has been bothering him for a while. Good enough to play today, they believe, at least the last they said. But it would seem if there's one player in football who can't afford to have a groin problem, perhaps it's the place kicker.
You're right, because the way most kickers kick now, kicking with the side of their foot, the groin muscles are used quite extensively with that. You go back to the old days where they used to kick with the toes. Those were the hip flexors. But now you use the groin muscles, which are what are called the hip adductors. That is, they pull the leg across the midline of the body. So any change in that function or any injury to that will have an effect on his kicking.
Well, he said that he heard it originally, or he felt it originally in the warm-ups before the Tennessee game. And then, mm-hmm. and then in the course of that game, he had to wind up kicking five field goals. And then
right.
they had the short week. They had to play 4 days later again on Thanksgiving. And he said he felt it again there. But now this week he said, well, I've had a little bit more rest. I'm feeling a little better. And the coaches have said he'll be fine. But I'm wondering, how much of it do you think might just be He's a young guy. He's first year in the NFL, and just dealing with the long season. I mean, this is probably longer. He's probably kicked the ball more this year than he's ever kicked it in his life. I mean, how much of it do you think is a tweak, and how much of it just might just be leg fatigue?
I think a lot. It sounds like it probably was more of a fatigue overuse injury, where even though these guys are in great shape, their muscles are incredibly well conditioned. Every time he kicks that football, it is just putting – it's like redlining an engine. Every time you kick that ball, you're putting all your force into it. So eventually your muscles can't take that, even in the well-trained athlete like this. And if it were a muscle – complete muscle tear or a – grade 2 strain of the muscle where there's partial tearing, he would have had an episode where he would have come in and said, you know what, I kicked that ball, and boy, I felt it there. When it just comes on slowly like that, or he just starts noticing it, probably more in fatigue and overuse, and it's something that you have to watch, because as he does more and more kicking, as they rely more and more on him, he has more likely chance to keep injuring that muscle.
Yeah, and of course, they can't exactly rest him. If rest is the answer, that's just not happening. Last question, Doc, and I understand he's not your patient, and you haven't seen him, but just as a rule of thumb, and I know you watch the Eagles, if called upon, could Cody Parkey deliver a 51-yard field goal today?
He could do it.
There you go.
You also have a risk, though, that he could re-injure that. I mean, I was looking back at his stats here, and the number of touchbacks he had and the number that he kicked into the end zone.
Significantly down, you're right.
Right, he dropped down. So you can see that little bit of change in his muscle probably is causing a slight decrease in his ability to kick those long distances.
Yeah, this is going to be something that we're going to all have to watch as the Eagles approach the playoffs. Boy, you don't want that to be a factor.
Right, and I know the doctors on the team and the trainers will definitely watch it. They don't want him to go out and tear his muscle further, but no one knows exactly what kick or what movement or what he does that will cause that to be damaged more, if it ever would.
Yep. And boy, we sure don't want to see it. Dr. Kevin Gingrich, thank you so much. And everybody should go to abingtoncheckup.com for more information on health issues. Doctor, have a great weekend. Enjoy the game today.
All right. You too. Thank you.
Thank you, Doctor.
Thank you for
win.
Joining us.
Right. Thank you, Doctor.
And one option is not sit him.
Yeah.
I mean, you just don't do that.
No, you can't. You can't. You don't want to go. But you don't want him to break down. And then you wind up re-signing Alex Henry for the playoffs.
Yeah, and you told the story.
I don't think anybody wants that.
No. You told the story yesterday about the Nick Mickemeyer case back in Vermeil in 78. They end up with Mike Michelle as the kicker, and it haunts him.
Right, yeah.